These are very important documents. Look, the binding, book binding in Ethiopia. The cover, wooden board cover, you know, as you see. Everything is made at home. So, this is 15th century manuscripts. Sometimes, you know, it's amazing that, you know, people in the 15th century, where they you know, aware of color, all the saints, even the Virgin, is painted black. You know, today, even today, we don't have, you don't find such paintings in churches, in monuments, always, you know, a bright color, not black color. So it has to be studied very, very well, you know, this type of documents. Look, even the evangelist, this is Matthew, you know, and the harag or the decorations, all this, you know, and as I told you at the beginning, piece of cloth to cover, it is cotton made, this is, you know, homemade cloth, so they protect it not to be destroyed, the painting. So this technology, look, this different signs, this is, you know, in different places, the full stops, you know, the title of the book, and the numbers, even, you know, what we see today and in the 15th century, they are different, you know, the transformation, you know, it has already changed. So these are very important to study, as I told you, different disciplines. The language and the linguistics, you know, the paleography, you know, the calligraphy, the paleography. Look, the position of these, all the ma and the sa, all these, the ha, all these are completely different from today's, you know, Ethiopian law. So this is very important for a paleographical study, very important for art history, very important, as I told you, for sociology and anthropology. So that is why this is a mining house. You know, that is why I say that this is a mining house where we can dig, you know, a lot of information from all these original sources. So this is very important manuscript. And then it is restored by an Italian expert, Carla Zanotti, almost 8 years ago. So this is one of our documents. As I told you, this is, of course, this is religious, as I told you, but it has also another information here, as I told you, colophons or marginal notes. This is, for example, this is Asmat prayer. So, to protect the owner of the book from different things, or to protect his animals not to be eaten by wild animals like hyena. They call it must agert. Look, this, you know, harag or decorative design. So this is the beginning of another book, that is the book of Mark, the evangelist Mark. So in every chapter, they design or they put such harags to indicate where it begins the other book. So this is it. If we see, yeah, and if we see this type of manuscript, as I told you, you know, there are so much concerned about these documents, about this very valuable material. They cover it first with, as I told you, it is covered with wood, and the wood is covered by another, you know, soft leather, and even for decoration, look, you know, it is covered inside, it is wood. After the wood, there is a cover of cloth. This cloth also, one has to study, as we are, the cloth which we have seen in this book and this are completely different. It shows that this is earlier and this is later. So this was imported, you know, clothes. So which type of clothes, from which place, that will indicate, you know. And then this is, we call it Morocco leather or the Tambay leather, because it is soft, to cover it. And then all the design, look here, this is a cross, you know, this is a cross. All the design was designed by the scribe, It has its own, you know, the scribe has his own instruments for making all these, you know, designs, decorations, and even, you know, the binding materials, complete material, from skin, that means from the skin of a goat to a book, they have complete, you know, materials for making them. Not only these decorative materials, writing materials, not only the writing materials, the inks, different types of inks, they prepare themselves in the local area from soil, plants, leaves, you know, fruits, and different types of materials. The color they want, whether it be yellow, green, red, they can make it. So all these are prepared in the local area. This is late 17th century manuscript, as you see. This manuscript is also printed, you know, and covered with this piece of cloth. This is Saint Raphael, not Raphael, Raphael, yes, Saint Raphael. These are, you know, the lives of different, you know, good men, protected by, you know, Raphael, and he is holding them in his wings. These are two wings, you know. So, and look the difference between this Harag and the previous Harag. So, the style, the painting, you know, the decorative design and the illuminations, they have their own style in every century, so that one can study these different styles with different. Look, this is King David, you know, the servants are standing nearby, and then not only that, they have, we call it chira, you know, to protect flies from the king, they hold here. And look, not only they hold, you know, the chiras, but they have combs in their hair, you know, hairstyle, look. You know, they have combs, and, you know, the crown of, you know, the king, typical Ethiopian type of crown. And, you know, debab, we call it this debab, is, you know, big umbrella, and seated king. So, as I told you, look how they dressed, you know. So this is very important for sociology and anthropology, you know, to study them. And this is a saint, you know. Look, the difference between this clothes and that clothes, you know. This type of, you know, clothes were not prepared in Ethiopia. There were no industries at that time. So these are imported, you know, clothes. So from which? From the East, from West, from Europe, from where? So it will lead you, or it makes you to do a research on these different materials. As I told you, these are very important for different studies. For example, if we see here, these are two religious fathers, you know. There is also two schools of thought in Ethiopia. So Abuna Eustathios and Abuna Tekla Haimanot are the two religious fathers of these two schools. So the followers of Eustathios and the followers of Tekla Haimanot. So still this, you know, practice, you know, continues in different parts in this religion. So look, this Harag, this is completely different from the other one. This one is with eyes. The other one, you know. So the beginning of the, this is, you know, image or salam. And then look these pieces of clothes, how they, you know, prepared it and covered it, this painting. Written by hand or one copy, carbon copy or typewritten or research paper, photographic archive, so that we have these different types of documents in this department. This is, as I told you, this document is not only the treasure of Ethiopia, it is the treasure of the world. So people can study how Africa was in the middle of, you know, in the Middle Ages, or in the 15th century, 16th century, you know, to study, the world should be, you know, studied, the north, south, east. So This represents, you know, Africa. As you know, Ethiopia is one of the ancient, you know, civilizations. It has its own alphabet. It has its own literature, so that one can, you know, read and understand what was there at that time. The people's thinking, psychological makeup, sociological, you know, activities, you know, bookmaking in Ethiopia, and then the technology itself should be studied. So these are very important documents, and we consider ourselves the keeper or custodian of Ethiopian and world's heritage.